안녕하세요, 여러분. 오늘은 제가 소매가 이놈이 잠을 안 자서 잠재우기 프로젝트를 하려고 왔습니다. 이렇게 멀뚱멀뚱히 깨어있는 솜솜이를 여러분이 잠자도록 도와주세요. 네, 구독과 좋아요는 필수고요. 우리 솜솜이는 항상 제 옆에서 이야기를 듣고 있을 것입니다. 저희 솜솜이는 천지 강아지여서, 천지견이어서, 무슨 말인지도 다 알아듣기 때문에, 이제 굿나잇 스토리 하면, 베드스토리 하면 이제 잠들 것입니다. 자, 여러분도 구독과 좋아요를 주신다면 저에게 힘이 될것 같습니다. 네, 그럼 바로 들어가겠습니다. 오늘 할 책은 저번에 뭐다못 읽었던 거 있죠? 프로페서 X로 들어가 보겠습니다. 자, 바로 이 부분이고요. 페이지는 43페이지입니다. 네, 그럼 바로 들어가겠습니다. Professor X. When Charles Seaver was a boy, he always listened when he heard other children talking about their dreams at night. They dreamed of winning soccer games or had dreams about being embraced. Charles' dreams were different. Charles knew he was not like other children. In his dreams, Charles' mind would leave his body and go flying over his town. Charles could hear people's thoughts below. It turned out Charles was reading people's minds. During his studies, Charles learned he was a mutant. He knew there had to be others like him. Charles traveled the world looking for mutants. In Egypt, after a long day of searching, Charles went into a cave. When he walked in the cave, he could not relax because he felt something he'd never felt before. There was another mutant nearby. Charles made eye contact with a large man in the room. He was really the mutant known as the Shadow King. Together, Magnus and Charles took on the Baron. The Baron had many weapons, but between Magnus' ability to move matter and Charles' mental powers, they turned the Baron's weapons against him. Defeated, he ran away. Charles and Magnus were successful, but the attack had changed them both. Magnus was convinced that humans were bad and not to be trusted. Magnus used his powers to steal the gold, but the Baron was stronger and inherited from the hospital. I shall use these words to form my plans to rule the world, Magnus said. And someday, my friend, you will see that I am right and join me. Charles just shook his head. Magnus' plan made Charles think about his own future. His father had left him a mansion and a fortune. Maybe he could use this to help both mutants and humanity. On his way home, Charles stumbled into a village where he sensed something was wrong. The minds of every person in the village were under a spell. Charles thought an evil mutant must be responsible. He searched the village, but did not find any. He then discovered a hidden underground basement filled with strange machines. Charles knew these machines were being used to control the villagers' minds. A frightening figure emerged from the shadows. "What are you?" Charles asked. "I am Lucifer. I am not from here," the alien said with an evil cackle. Lucifer threw the handle as he fled from the room, releasing a giant stone from the ceiling of Lucifer's secret hideaway. Charles couldn't dodge it in time. The stone fell on him, and he lost the use of his legs. Instead of feeling sad about what he had lost, Charles thought about everything he needed to build. Charles returned to the mansion where he had grown up. The house was dusty and empty, but it wouldn't stay that way for long. Charles got right to work creating the first part of his dream, a school for young mutants. He would name it Saber's School for Gifted Youngsters. The end. 와, 여러분 엄청 일찍 끝났죠? 한번 소미가 잠드는지 볼까요? 보겠습니다. 이 소미가 곤히 잠들었군요, 여러분.
진짜?
오, 네,
진짜?
놀랐습니다. 저희 형도 지금 놀랐습니다. 여러분, 이거 실제 상황입니다. 여러분, 기억하십시오. 구독과 좋아요 필수. 잠들었으니 필수입니다. 네, 그러면 저는 인사드리겠습니다. 감사드립니다.
인사드립니다.
바이바이.